Today we're going to be doing some density separation with a Mount Baker mining and metal shaker table. We're going to try and separate some of this dense metal alloy from this other black stuff that I think is carbon fiber. We're going to screen it down to a size that we can put on the shaker table. The shaker table will separate the metal from the carbon fiber, and we should end up with clean metal alloy and clean carbon fiber at the end. I really like these videos where we're going to play with some of this stuff people have a problem with, and there's still a lot of value left in here. This is a waste stream they're currently throwing away. If they can get all this metal out, they can reuse it. So the first thing we're going to do here is we're going to screen this down because there's some material in here that's too big to go directly onto our shaker table. The shaker table can take up to about an 1/8 inch piece, which I think is about 3 or 4 millimeters. And if it's any larger than that, the water action isn't able to separate the particles by density. Now we have our two products. We have our 1/8 inch and smaller screened. So let's go get that ready for the shaker table. This is the larger stuff here, and we'll play with that a little bit later in the video. The shaker table always runs better if you can start with a slurry. So I'm gonna mix some water in with this first, so then we can add it directly to the shaker table, and we won't worry about any of the stuff that floats. We can get all that sunken down so we have just a nice wetted material. See, it's all still dry. It doesn't work very well if you try and put super dry material on the shaker table. It just floats on the water, as you can see there. I found the best thing to use for these small samples is just a paint stirrer on a drill. And you just start real slow, and you mix up the whole batch. Now we're going to use this Mount Baker Mining and Metals 4x8 shaker table. And this thing is just like a big gold pan. It's a density separator. We put a little bit of water on top of the table surface, and we're going to pour our slurry in this aluminum distributor trough. The metal alloy is very dense, so it's going to go right down through the water column and get caught in these grooves. And all that carbon fiber or whatever that material is going to flow off the table on into the tailings trough down at the bottom of the table here. The metal is going to work its way across the grooves this way up under the water bar onto the cleaning plane, and then work its way down into the number one and the number two concentrates here. So we should have really nice clean metal here, and all the carbon fiber is going to go into the waste. I just finished the run, and all the light gray stuff coming down this side is all pure metal. It's working its way right down into the number one. The number two is also pretty much pure metal. There might be a little bit of carbon fiber in there, but this stuff right here is just, it's just metal. And it's even capturing the super, super fine stuff. You can see it a lot better up here, actually. See how fine all that is? All this stuff coming across the top. It's the super, super fine metal. And then the coarser stuff is a little bit down behind it, but it all works its way right over into the number one there. For the oversized material, I think a Mount Baker Mining and Metals 16x12 hammer mill could take all the material. You could run some water down the hammer mill to make a very nice slurry that would feed directly onto the shaker table, and that would break all the material small enough so you wouldn't have to screen anything out. The number four tailings would come down into the spiral classifier. This would dewater all of the carbon fiber up into a super sack, just like we do with ore. And then all the overflow could come down into a tank and be recirculated through the system over and over and over again. Here's our three samples, and this is the number one off the shaker table. And like I showed you earlier, it's just pure metal. I mean, the container, this little container is so heavy. It's only about half full, but it probably weighs 10 or 15 pounds. And it's got all the fines in it, a lot of the bigger pieces. So that's where all the pure metal went. And then here's the number two. This one doesn't have as much. There's a little bit of larger pieces of resin, but not much. I don't know what the spec is or what this customer needs. But once you get past that carbon fiber, which may have come in when I brushed down the table, that's also pretty much just pure metal. So the number one and the number two caught pretty much all of the good stuff. All the goodies are right here. And here's a little bit I could catch in the number four. I was running around trying to feed the shaker table and take video and do all the stuff. But that is just straight carbon fiber or resin, whatever it is, waste. There's no metal in there at all. The container doesn't weigh hardly anything. And then here's the stuff we screened out earlier. I was gonna pan this down and do a bunch of stuff to it, but I think what I'm gonna do is just send it back to the customer like this. This is everything that's 1/8 inch and larger, and they can take a look at it. A hammer mill would do a great job of breaking up all this metal pieces, all these little pieces. It would shatter all this plastic. Oh, broke my glove. It would shatter all this just in no time, make a really nice slurry, and it would all go right down onto the shaker table, and it would all get cleaned up so quick and so nice. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you would like any more information on the equipment we sell, you can find our contact information in the description below. So thanks everybody for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.